Mr. Mandeep.
I am an aerospace engineer. I am connected with Aircruise Education Private Limited as an aviation manager. You can visit the site by clicking on www.aircruiseaviation.com. So today I am going to talk about night operations. So this is my bio. You can connect me on social sites also. So let's get started with the today's topic, that is night operations. So the mechanical operation of an airplane at night is no different than operating the single plane during the day. The airplane does not know if it is being operated in the dark or bright sunlight. It performs and responds to control input by the pilot. The pilot, however, is affected by the various aspects of night operations and must take them into consideration during night flight operations. Some are actual physical limitation affecting all pilots, while others such as equipment requirements, procedures, and emergency situations must also be considered. So the flying in the day is a real different as in flying in the night, although a machine doesn't know well it is being operated in the daytime or nighttime. So it is all about a pilot, how he handles all the situations. So the generally most pilots are poorly informed about night vision. Human eyes never function effectively at night as the eyes of the human with nocturnal habits. So operating an aircraft during night time, so the main function over there has to be of the lights. So let us have a look how lights play a very, very important role in the flying at the night time. So here you can see a picture showing two red lights and one white light at the tail end. So let us get started and have a good knowledge about what are these lights about. So this is the cockpit view at the night time, and here a pilot have a very dizzy view outside the cockpit, that is the head-up display. So you can see a thunderstorm also, and the visibility is really very less. So how come pilot do operate an aircraft in such situations? So for that, an aircraft needs to have various machines, various systems to operate. So before beginning a night flight, carefully consider personal equipment that should be readily available during the flight, to include a flashlight, aeronautical charts, and pertinent data for the flight, and a flight deck checklist containing procedures for the following tasks, which can be found in 14 CFR Part 91. So for that, we need to follow before starting engines, before takeoff, cruise, before landing, after landing, stopping engines, as well as emergencies. So the red light, which here we can see, these are basically the anti-collision lights, which are in red in color. So these are the top and the bottom of the aircraft and are often called rotating beacons. So the white lights at the wingtips of an aircraft, these are the anti-collision lights, which are white in color. So on each wingtip, we have a white light. Sometimes it is also on the tail, and these are often called strobes. So here we can see the different lights at the different places of aircraft. First, we have the logo light, which is mounted on the horizontal stabilizer, and sometimes it is also mounted on the wingtips also. So this is basically the light point to highlight the logo of an airline, which is at the tail section of the aircraft. Next to that, we have wing inspection lights. So this is illuminate wing used for the inspection, increase the aircraft visibility. So next to that, we have the anti-collision lights, which is white, which I told you earlier, that is situated on the each wingtip of an aircraft. So sometimes it is also on the tail, and these are often called strobes. So next to that, we have position lights. These are also known as navigation lights. So for forward facing, we have on the left side, we have red light, and on the right side, we have green light. For the rear facing, we have the white line. So next to that, we have alternative landing light system. So here, these are the white lights you can see on the aircraft. These are the alternative landing light system. Next to that, we have landing light. So this is basically used for the runway illumination on landing gear, fuselage. After that, we have anti-collision light, which is red color. So these are situated top or bottom of the aircraft and often called rotating beacons. So at the last, we have runway turnoff and taxi lights. These are not as bright as landing lights, and these are used runway exits and taxiways. So here from a broad picture showing the different lights, like at the nose we have the taxi light, then next we have some lights which is used for wing illumination light, then next to that on the fuselage part we can see retractable landing light, and then next to that we have runway turn off light. And after that, on a wing, we can see a fixed landing light. After that, we have upper and lower anti-collision lights. Just after that, we have strobe light, which is situated on the wingtip of an aircraft. Next to that, we have position light, which is used for positioning of an aircraft. After that, we have logo light, which is at the tail section of an aircraft to highlight the logo of an airline. Then next, we have strobe light, which is at the tail of the aircraft. Just so that we have some showing the positioning system. So at the night time, how we can see the position of an aircraft. So if you see a red, if you see a white as well as green light, like white light at the left and green light at the right. So aircraft is moving from left to the right. So if you see a red light on the left and white light on the right, so that means that aircraft is moving right to left. And if you see a green light on the left side and a red light on the right side, which means the aircraft is coming to your direction. And if you see red light on the left side, then in middle you see the white light, and at the right side you see green light. That means the aircraft is coming, going away from you. That means aircraft is outgoing. These are the basic positioning light, that is red, green, and white. And how wide it goes, ten degrees from the wingtips and 140 degrees from the tail section of the aircraft. So the positioning system is easily can be shown from this picture. So if we see two white lights, so it is showing that the aircraft is facing away. So if you see one green light as well as one right light, red light, so that means that aircraft is coming towards you. And if we took, if we take a look from the top view, and if you see the red light on the left and the green light on the right, then this means that you are above that plane. And if you see a green light, then it means that it is facing, it is going right. And if you see the red light on the left, then it means the aircraft is facing left. So this is how about the aircraft positioning. So next to that, we have runway, which plays an initial role for the landing of an aircraft at the night time. So the lighting on the aircraft is usually plays a basic role to aircraft, to basically for a pilot to have a clear view on a runway. So what these different lights on a runway signifies. So first we have the approaching lights, which you can see, which is just from the runway, that is, then after that, the threshold lights we have from where the yellow light starts. Before that, we have the red lights, which are the basically approach lights. Then next to that, we have the runway center line lights, which signifies the center of a runway. so which enables an aircraft to see a clear center of the runway. Then next to that, we have the runway end lights. So here, that is the end of the runway. And to the left, we can see the touchdown zone lights. So at this zone, an aircraft has to touch down during landing. And then we have the taxiway light. The blue light apart a little left to the runway shows the taxiway light that after the landing, where the aircraft has to taxi to the hangar. So there is another runway light description here. So here you can see some red lights, some of the green, white as well. So basically here the white lights you can see, these are the runway edge lights. So these are basically showing the edges of the runway. Next to that, we have yellow lines, which is also highlighting the edges of the runway. Next to that, we have small white lights. You can see small dots. So these are the runway center line lights. So a big white dot shows the runway edge lights. And if the size of the light goes more, then it is runway center line lights. So next to that, we have lights that is showing yellow, green, and then yellow. So these are the exit taxiway lead of lights. Next to that, we have a red as well as a green. So these are the runway end or threshold lights. So a bright white light, this is basically runway end identifier light. So these are basically a bit brighter to tell that the runway has the end at this position. So next to that, we have the PAPI, that is Precision Approach Path Indicator aircraft, which enables while landing of an aircraft. So the red dots here, we can see the precision of an aircraft. So it is basically the altitude with respect to the ground or with respect to the runway. If we have four the dots red, then it is too low as it is required to be. And if it is showing three red dots, then it is a bit low. And if it's showing two red dots and two white dots, then we are following the correct path. And if it is showing only a single red dot, then the aircraft is at the high. And if all the dots are white, then it is too much high. So for a correct precision, an aircraft has to be with two red dots and two white dots. So now we have the taxiway lights. So at the center, that green lights we have, we can see these are the taxiway center line. Then next, the blue lights here, we can see these are the taxiway edge lights. Next to that, the yellow light here, we can see these are the runway guard lights. And the red lights here, you can see these are the steady bar lights. And next to that, the yellow lights, these are the clearance bar lights. So here is another description about the taxiway light. So here we can see different light. The first one, that is blue. This shows the taxiway edge lights. Next to that, we have the green light. So these are the center lights. After that, we have red light, which means the stop bar lights. Next to that, we have yellow light, that is two in a pair. So these are the runway guard lights. And the yellow light in continuous, this is the clearance bar light. So after that, the line, you can see these are the taxiway hold lines. So here you can hold the aircraft. So next to that, we have the runway hold line. So here aircraft can hold on the runway. So another brief description from the pilot view while landing. So here we can clearly see the approaching light system, which is mostly red in color. Then after that, we have runway and identification light. Then here the green light, we can see that is the runway end light. Then after that, we have the touchdown zone lights. Then we also have the runway edge lights as well as the runway centerline system. And here also we have the PAPL light system, which shows the altitude of an aircraft. So basically at the nighttime instrument landing system, the landing system which is used to land an aircraft, it plays a basic role at the nighttime, because sometimes the view outside the cockpit is not clear due to various weather conditions. So at that time, a person has to depend on the machines. So instrument landing system is a system which enables an aircraft to coordinate with the runway points as well as the aircraft points, and helps it to tell coordination and the direction of an aircraft, whether it is coming on the same way or going on a different coordinate. So instrument landing system helps to coordinate for a perfect landing on an aircraft. So sometimes from when a pilot views from cockpit, so there are some illusions we can say. So there some be some like misunderstanding while the view. So if a runway is narrower, so on a first picture we can see the normal approach is on the dotted lines, represented as the dotted lines, the yellow dotted lines. And the red line here, you can see the approach due to illusion, which a pilot sees. So on a narrow runway, pilot might see a runway a bit before as compared it is normally it is. So in such cases, instrument landing system enables to give the perfect coordinates while an aircraft is going on a perfect path or not. So next to that, on a different, like in the first position, an aircraft is very much down, very much near to the aircraft. So its altitude is very low. In next picture, we can see the aircraft having at such an altitude. So if a pilot sees from head-up display, so the approach due to illusion will be after some point in the runway. But a normal approach shows from the starting point of the runway. So these are the illusions which might create, that can be due to different weather conditions also. So next to that, we have another, if narrower the runway is, so how illusion can be created. And if an aircraft is, this is another view, how a pilot might be mistaken due to the views. So the bright lights can cause a blinding effect also. So during roundout and flare, there are much of the brighter lights. So that also outside view. So bright lights just points the outside view, and that also may create some misunderstandings. So this is the black hole. So what the black hole approach illusion occurs when the approaching a runway at night or in poor visibility with no lights before the runway and with city lights or rising terrain beyond the runway. These conditions may produce a visual illusion of a high altitude final approach. If you believe this illusion, you may respond by descending below the normal approach slope. So there are various factors which might effect into the visual illusions, like poor visibility as well as the light, city lights might confuse with the runway lights also. So there are the basic factors which might happen to the visual illusion basically at the night time. So for that, an instrument for that and machine has to depends upon its instruments, upon the systems, upon the electronic systems into it. So this is my bio. If you wish, you can connect me on the today's topic. So thank you so much for listening to me.